Hi guys, my name is Ferdy and in this video I want to show you how you can add a add to wishlist button on your WooCommerce website like this. I have my webshop over here and if I see a product, I can add it to my wishlist by clicking here and then I can view my wishlist. And if I want to, I can select certain products or all of them and add them to the cart. And if I view the cart, now they are added. So in this video, I will show you how to achieve that. So if you're new here, please consider to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials. And then I would like to say, let's get started. I have my website over here with the Estra theme and the Elementor page builder, two free tools, and WooCommerce is also free. So if I go to the shop, I see those products and I can click over here and I can add them to the cart. But what I want to add is a button like add it to the wishlist so people can dream about the product they want to have. They want to have a 1 hour Zoom session with Ferdy. They don't have the money yet. They want to wish it. So they add it to their wish list so they can dream about it and be happy and like, oh, one day I have the money to do that. By the way, this is a fake product, so you cannot do this. I'm sorry. So what I want to do, I want to go to the backend and then I want to go to plugins, add new, and then I search for wish list. And then there's a really popular one over here. We're not going to use that one. I think it's too complicated, but I want to use this one from Template Invaders in 70,000 installations and 232 reviews and all 5 stars. So I click on install now. Then we wait a second and then I click on activate. Then we need to walk through a wizard. We need to set it up, the setup wizard. So you need to click on let's go. Then a new page will be added called default wishlist. And over here it says automatic. You need to leave it over there. And over here I would like to say wishlist. Then I click on continue and now the wishlist page will be created. So the button options, what do I want to show? Do I want to have a button position after the add to cart button or before the add to cart button or a custom position with code? Well, I want to use after the add to cart. So you can add it to the cart on a product page and below you can add it to your wish list. Do I want to show this in the listing? So when I have an overview of all the products in my shop, do I want to have it over there? Yes. And, or you can say no, it's up to you. I say yes. And then I click on continue. How products should be removed. So when a product that you have on your wish list, when you order it, should it be removed from your wish list? Well, I guess so, because then you don't need it anymore on your wish list because you have it in real life. So I click on automatically continue. And do you want to share your wish list? Well, I don't want it for this website. So I turn everything off or I skip this step. And then it says your wish list is ready. And then we can scroll down and return to the WordPress dashboard. I have an update. I will leave it for later. Now I can go to my website. I hold command and I click over here. Then I can go to my shop and what I will see, I can add it to my wish list. If you don't want this, you can go back to the backend and then over here somewhere, TI wishlist, general settings, you can turn it off again. Then I scroll down. Let me see product page, add to wishlist. Okay, that's okay. Product listing button settings. So show in product listing, I can turn it off. And if I save it over here and I refresh the page, you will not see it here anymore. And now I can click over here and there it is, add to wishlist. If I click over here, I can view the wishlist, and then it looks like that. Awesome. I can go back to the shop to a different product, this one. And I can add this one to the wishlist, view it. And there it is. Now I added them all. I can remove it over here. I don't want it anymore. I only want to have the 64. So I want to have a Zoom session with Ferdy and a USB stick. And if I want to add them all to the cart, I can do that over here. But if I go back to the shop, or I can click on one of those products, I can also give this a style. So I can go back to the settings and then I go to style options. I leave this on and I also say template custom CSS. Then you can go to ferdycorp.com. Then you go to tutorials and here it says WooCommerce wishlist tutorial. This is all wrong. This needs to be updated, but I'm recording this video right now. There's a style You can copy it. And what it's saying is that the product button should have a background with this color and the text color of this one. It should be bold and it should have this padding. And when I hover over it, it has a different color over here and everything is the same. So I go to the settings, I paste it over here. And what will happen now, if I go to the shop and I go to a certain product, it looks like this. If you want to change the color, you can grab a color over here, copy it. If you want to use this tool, I use Google Chrome and it's called the Color Pick Eyedropper. I have a tutorial about it, so you can find it over here or in the description. I go to the back end to TI wishlist, style options, and then if I would replace the color over here and I save it and I refresh this, it has this color from my, what's it called, sweater? I don't know. That is what will happen. So let's take it to the next level. I have a tutorial here about WooCommerce and I also have a wishlist over here. So if I would go to /wishlist, I see a few products already. Well, what I want to do, I want to log in. And now I want to add a wishlist over here. So you can go to the menu and add the wishlist space, but like my account and then as a sub item wishlist or an icon. So I want to edit the header, the Elementor header. I made this with Elementor Pro. You can get this for free. If you go to Ferdicorp and then to templates, you can import this if you have Elementor Pro. And over here, there's an icon. Let me see this icon. I can duplicate it, drag it over here, or I go to the navigator and I drag it on top. Then I go to advanced, padding, right, increase it a bit more. Then I want to go to the content. I change the icon to a heart, or better this one, insert, and then the link. /wishlist. I can also make it red if I want to. Update. And if I take a look now, I go to the homepage, I can go to my wishlist. And that's what you can do. So that's how you can have a wishlist. And if I go back to my wishlist of my free website, add to the wishlist, view the wishlist. Wishlist, what a stupid word. Really hard to say. I can select certain products or I can add all the products to the cart. And now if I view the cart, they're transferred from the wishlist to the cart. So that's what you can do with this wishlist plugin. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Good luck with this. And I hope a lot of people will add a lot of products to your wishlist on your website. And then they can sell a lot of stuff. They can dream about it, they can save money, and then they finally can buy it and they are happy because they had it on their wish list. Have a great day, and you will see me when you see me in the grocery store. It's in the Netherlands, in Maassluis. I go to the Albert Heijn sometimes, so if you shop there, there's a slight chance you will see me. But often we order our groceries, so they will be added. They will brought to our house. This video is already quite long, so I will finish it. Yeah, you can cut now. Yeah. Come on, intern. Turn it off. Turn it off! Are you serious?